Hello dear children, hope you all are good and doing well at your home. Myself Diksha Rai, this is your subject teacher of computer from Alpium Public School, which is situated in Kola Bazar, Gorakhpur. So my dear students, in this video, we are going to revise the chapter number 4, that is handling a mouse and touchpad. And even in this video, I will tell you that what will the pattern come in your periodic assessment term 2. In your previous video, you have already learned about chapter number 3, that is operating a computer. And I hope you will be revise the exercise of chapter number 3 from your homework copy. Now, let us start the chapter number 4, that is handling a mouse and touchpad. So now we are going to discuss about the first topic from your chapter number 4, is that computer mouse. As you know, there are two buttons in a mouse and a scroll wheel. A mouse has two buttons and a scroll wheel. They are called left buttons and right buttons. The scroll wheel is used to move a page up and down on the monitor. This is called scrolling. The mouse is also called a pointing device. So my dear students, on your page, as you can see, this is a picture of mouse and there are two buttons in mouse. Number first is that left button, number second is that right button, and in the middle of mouse there are present a scroll wheel, and the scroll wheel is used to move a page up and down on the monitor. This is called scrolling. The mouse is also called a pointing device. Now, do you know that how many types of a mouse? A mouse uses either a ball or light for the movement of the mouse pointer. A mouse can be used for many things, such as pointing an item, selecting items, playing games, and drawing and coloring. Number first is that ball mouse, and number second is that optical mouse. So first we will read about ball mouse. This mouse uses a ball for the movement of the mouse pointer. The ball, rubber or metal, is present on its underside. So now we are going to discuss about ball mouse. This mouse uses a ball for the movement of the mouse pointer. The ball, rubber or metal, is present its underside. So now we are going to discuss about the second type of mouse, that is optical mouse. This mouse uses an LED light for the movement of mouse pointer. So now we are going to again revise the second type of mouse, is that optical mouse. This mouse uses an LED light for the movement of mouse pointer. So now we are going to discuss about information box. A pad on which a mouse is kept is called mouse pad. Now we are going to discuss about mouse actions. A mouse helps us to perform the following actions. Number first is that click, number second is that double click, and number third is that right click, and number four is that drag and drop. And number fifth is that scrolling. A mouse helps us to perform the following actions. Number first is that click, number second is that double click, and number third is right click, and number fourth is drag and drop, and number fifth is number second is that double click, and number third is right click, and number fourth is drag and drop, and number fifth is scrolling. So now we are going to discuss about click. A mouse makes a click sound when its left button is pressed. Clicking selects an item or any option on the desktop. Now try the click action. Bring the pointer on any icon on the desktop and click on it once. So now we are going to discuss about double click. Quickly pressing the left mouse button twice is called double click. Double clicking opens an item on the desktop. Quickly pressing the left mouse button twice is called double click. Double clicking opens an item on the desktop. Try the double click action. Place the pointer on this PC, and the full form of PC is that personal computer. This PC icon on the desktop and double click on it, the file explorer window opens. Place the pointer on this PC. This PC icon on the desktop and double click on it, the file explorer windows open. So now we are going to discuss about right click. Pressing the right click mouse button once is called the right click action. Right clicking on any items open a list of commands. So now we are going to again discuss about the right click. Pressing the right mouse button once is called the right click action. Right clicking on any item opens a list of commands. Try the right click action. Bring the pointer over this PC icon and right click. A list of commands opens. Try the right click action. Bring the pointer over this PC, and the full form of PC is called personal computer. Icon and right click. A list of commands open. Drag and drop. Dragging means to move item on the monitor. While pressing the left mouse button. Now we will discuss about dropping. Dropping means to place the dragged item in another place on the monitor. Dragging means to move an item on the monitor while pressing the left mouse button. Dropping means to place the dragged item in another place on the monitor. So now we are going to discuss about try the drag and drop action. Select this PC icon, drag the icon to another place on the desktop. Select this PC icon, drag the icon to another place on the desktop. Now we are going to discuss about scrolling. Scrolling means to move the page up and down. Scrolling action is done using the scroll wheel. Scrolling means to move the page up and down. Scrolling action is done using the scroll wheel. Moving the scroll wheel forward moves a page up, and moving the scroll wheel backward moves a page down. Moving the scroll wheel forward moves a page up, and moving the scroll wheel backward moves a page down. Now we are going to discuss about touchpad. A touchpad is a flat touch sensitive surface on a laptop. It is an inbuilt pad that works like a mouse. It can sense the movements and tapping of the fingers. It is divided into three sections. Number first is that left click area. Number second is that right click area. And number third is that pointer controlling area. Now again we are going to discuss about touchpad, because it is a very important topic for all of you. A touchpad is a flat touch sensitive surface on a laptop. It is an inbuilt pad that works like a mouse. It can sense the movements and tapping of the fingers. It is divided into three sections. Number first is that left click area. Number second is that right click area. And number third is that pointer controlling area. Left click area acts like a left mouse button. Left click area act like a left mouse button. And number second, right click area acts like a right mouse button. Number third, pointer controlling area is used for moving the pointer on the monitor. So as you can see, this one is left click area, and this one is right click area, and this is pointer controlling area. Now we are going to discuss about information box. George E. Galfrey invented the first touchpad in 1988. The touchpad was first used in the PowerBook laptops of Apple computer in 1994. So my dear students, from this topic your chapter has ended. Now I'm going to ask you the question and answer of this chapter, that answer the following questions. You will see in your page number 34, what are the uses of computer mouse? A computer mouse is used for pointing an item, playing games, drawing and coloring. Differentiate between left click and right click. Left click select an option, while right click select and open the list of commands. And now the very important question of the what is a touchpad? Name three sections that is divided into. A touchpad is a flat touch sensitive area. Number first is that left click area. Number second is that right click area. And number third is that pointer controlling area. So my dear students, from this question sir, your exercise of chapter number 4, that is handling a mouse and touchpad, has completed. And you will do the exercise of chapter number 4 in your PC copy. When school will reopen, I will check your PC